So the next topic is Baer-Moore algorithm. See, basically the Baer-Moore algorithm is a pattern matching algorithm, and I will just discuss how the pattern is matched with the text. Before this, all of you have seen the Horsfall algorithm of how to particularly match the pattern with the text. In this case, we'll see another algorithm called as Baer-Moore algorithm, which will again match the pattern with the text. But there is a slight difference between this algorithm and the Horsfall algorithm. So initially, we will compute the bad shift table using this formula d1 is equal to t1c minus k, where say c is the text character that has caused the mismatch, and t1c is the shift table value of the c character, and k is the number of matched characters. So let us see this example. Suppose you want to search for a pattern called barber. Fine. Now, computing the bad shift table for this barber is same as that of Horsfall. So if you remember, we'll start with E. E is at a distance of 1. So E is equal to 1. B is at a distance of 2. So B is equal to 2. R is at a distance of 3. R is equal to 3. A is at a distance of 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. So A is equal to 4. But B was already calculated. So B is again 2. Right? I hope all of you remember this. This is how we used to calculate the shift table for a pattern in the Horsfall algorithm. So this bad shift table construction in the Baer-Moore is same. Fine, we will calculate the shift values for each character of the pattern. Now let us observe this. There is a little difference here. See, for example, suppose some of the characters in the pattern match with the text. For example, please see here in this diagram, this particular line SER, this is the text, suppose sample text, and barber is the pattern. Now as you can see, R is matched with R, E is matched with E, but the mismatch occurs here. If you see, B is not matched with S, right? So now we apply this formula T1C minus K. What is C? He says C is the particular text character that has caused the mismatch. In this case, C is the S. Okay, please observe here. Okay, this is the character. S is the character where the mismatch has happened. Now you take its shift value. What is the shift value of S? All of you, I think, know that shift value of S is equal to 6 because it is not present in the pattern, right? So shift value of S is 6. 6 minus K. What is K? K is the number of matched characters, E and R. So K is the matched characters. So T1S is the shift value of the mismatched character of the text, that is S. I hope all of you are following. So here what happens is we are doing 6 minus 2. Shift value of S is 6 and the number of matched characters is 2. So 6 minus 2, 4. 4 positions this pattern gets shifted. Fine, this is one way. This is called bad shift. The next one is good suffix table. This is the difference. This particular thing is the difference between Baer-Moore and the Horsfall algorithm. Okay, please see here, for this pattern, for a particular pattern, he has shown how the good suffix table is computed. Now if you observe, ABC, BAB is the pattern. In this case, if you observe, the last character B, okay, it is matching with the rightmost B. So if this B has to match, if it be this B has to come here, then the number of positions it has to shift, the pattern has to shift is 2, right? 1, 2. That's why D2 is 2. Similarly, please observe this. AB. Now, where does this AB come in this pattern? It comes here, right? Now, if you want to shift this AB here, then this entire AB has to be shifted 4 times, 1, 2, 3, 4, so that this B gets matched with B and this A gets matched with A. So this AB has to be shifted here 4 times. Next, you please see where BAB is present. BAB, actually only part of it, AB is present here. And in order to shift this AB here, again this AB has to be shifted 4 times, 4 positions. so that it matches this BAB. Similarly, CBAB. Find CBAB. In this again, only AB matches here. And if you want to shift this AB to the rightmost, then again you have to shift this AB 1, 2, 3, 4 times. Similarly, last one is BCBAB. Now if you see BCBAB, again, this last A is there. This A has to be again shifted 1, 2, 3, 4 times to match here. So what the Beuermann algorithm does is, it will calculate two distances, fine, D1. D1 is the distance what we saw previously, D1 is equal to T1C minus K, and D2 is this distance. And the pattern gets shifted to the maximum value of D1 and D2. So you'll better understand when we go for the problem. This is a standard problem given here. Please observe here, the text is BESS, BESS underscore new about BAOBAS. This is the text, please observe. And BAOBAB is the pattern, fine. Now, please see here, when we align this pattern here, B is not matching with K, fine. B is not matching with K. Whenever there are zero matches, then we blindly compute D1. What is D1? Please remember, D1 is equal to T1 C minus K, fine. Which is the mismatched character here? K. And what is the shift value of K? 6. 6 minus number of matched characters is 0. 6 minus 0 is 6. So this BAOBAB pattern gets shifted 6 times. Please observe here. It gets shifted 6 times. Whenever there is 0 matches, we only calculate T1, which is the bad shift. We don't calculate the D2, which is the good shift. Okay. Now please observe. Now after shifting here, please see, B is matched with B, A is matched with A, B has mismatched with underscore. So now calculate D1. What is D1? D1 is equal to T1, the shift value of underscore. What is the shift value of underscore? 6. Correct? 6 minus how many characters that is matched? 2. 6 minus 2 is 4. D1 is 4. Now if you observe D2, now D2 has to be calculated. How will you calculate D2? If you want to bring this AB, okay, if you want to, if you see, observe here, here he has calculated the good suffix table. If you see here, this B, fine, this B, if it has to be shifted to, it will match the last character B will match with the rightmost B, and this B has to, if it has to match here, it has to be shifted 2 times. Fine. Now please take this AB. Now AB together, it is not present anywhere in the pattern. If you see here, AB is not present anywhere in the pattern, but this B matches with the first B. We'll not take this second B because it is previous to this B, O is there. So OB doesn't match with AB, but previous to this first B, there might be A. So what he's doing is, he's shifting this B rightmost. If you want to shift this B to the rightmost, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This B has to be shifted 5 times. Fine. Okay, similarly, here what happens is, this BAB, okay, this BAB, where it occurs in the pattern? It occurs nowhere. Right, but only one B is remaining. So the logic is, this BAB, this B can be matched with the rightmost B, fine, by shifting it 5 times. Why we are not matching this B with the this B, fine? That question may arise. That is because if we clip this B to here, then the remaining characters, the before this B and after this B, may not match. So we are going to shift this character to the rightmost B, and it is 5 times. Similarly, as it done for the other things. Fine. So the basic logic is, now if you see here, what he has done is, the shift value of underscore minus 2 he has done. So shift value of underscore is the shift value of underscore, if you see, shift value of underscore was 6 minus 1, 5, and D2 is 2. Fine. Because here only B is matched and if you see here, d2 is 2. So maximum of 5 and 2 is 5, and the BOBAB gets shifted 5 times. Now I'll just summarize the logic behind Bowyer-Mohr is, if there are no matched characters, see for example here, if there are no matched characters, immediately the mismatch has occurred. Then you just calculate d1. How do you calculate d1? D1 is equal to shift value of the mismatched character of the text minus the number of characters matched. Fine. If some of the characters of the pattern match with some of the characters of the text, then you have to calculate d1 and d2 both and shift the pattern by the maximum of d1 and d2. Fine. D1 is easier, d2 is little tricky. So I'll examine further problems so that you may better understand it. Okay, let us take this another example. He has taken text as stou underscore tor underscore stor and pattern is stor. Now please calculate the good suffix table for this pattern stor. Start with the rightmost character r. Now r, it occurs nowhere in the pattern, so the length of d2 is 4. Or if you take, it occurs nowhere in the pattern, again d2 is 4. Tor if you take, it occurs nowhere in the pattern, it is 4. Fine. And bad shift table is simple. You just calculate as it is same as the Hausspool algorithm. So the shift value of O is 1, shift value of T is 2, shift value of S is 3, and other characters will be the length of the pattern STOR. Now go on matching here. R is not matching with U. So just calculate D1. What is D1? The shift value of U minus number of matched characters, which is 0 here. So what is shift value of U? Shift value of U is 4. So 4 minus 0 is 4. Will shift the STOR 4 times. It comes here. Now R is matched with R, O is matched with O, T is matched with T, but S is not matched with underscore. So some of the characters of the pattern has matched with some of the characters of the text. In this case, you have to calculate both D1 and D2. Fine. What is D1? D1 is equal to shift value of this underscore mismatched character minus number of characters that has matched. 3. 4 minus 3 is 1. And what is D2? D2 is nothing but, here if you see, the three characters have matched. So if three characters match, the shift value is 4. 4, correct? But so what we'll do, maximum of 1 and 4 is 4. So this STOR gets shifted 4 times. Similarly, next R is compared with O. There is a mismatch. So when there is a mismatch immediately, then you just calculate D1. What is D1? D1 is equal to shift value of O minus the number of matched characters. Here zero characters are matched. What is shift value of O? Shift value of O is 1. So 1 minus 0 is 1. So you get shifted STOR one place to the right and it gets matched. So this is one example where Bowyer-Mohr has been implemented. Let us examine another problem. Okay, please observe here. This is another problem. This is the text. Okay. Some random text is given and this is the pattern. Now you calculate the good suffix table for AJIJI. Okay. Now start with the rightmost character. Which is the rightmost character? I. Where I occurs here? In the rightmost way? Here. Correct? One marked with yellow. So if you want to bring this I here, you have to shift it 2 times. Right? That's what D2 is 2. Now take next two characters, JI. Where JI occurs? This is what I have marked yellow here. So if you want to shift this JI to match this, then you have to shift the JI 2 places to the right. That's why D2 is 2. Next, IJI. IJI doesn't occur anywhere. So the D2 is the length of the pattern 5. Then similarly, JIJI, it doesn't occur anywhere in the pattern. So the D2 is 5. Fine. And bad shift table is same as Hausspool algorithm. You start with J. J is 1. I is the shift value of I is 2. And J is 1. Again, A is 4. Other characters have the length of the pattern 5. Now start matching here. I is matched with I, J is matched with J, I is mismatched with J. So now what you should do is you have to calculate both D1 and D2 because some of the characters have matched. What is D1? D1 is equal to the shift value of the mismatched character D minus the number of characters that have matched, that is 2 here. What is the shift value of D? The shift value of D is equal to 5 minus 2, 3. Fine. And what is D2? D2 you have to see here because here J and J are matched. So here J, if you if you want to match, correct, then the d2 is 2. Fine, the maximum value of 3 and 2 is 3. So you shift this pattern AJIJ 3 times to the right. Next, again, he matches I with E. Immediate mismatch. So just calculate d1. d1 is equal to shift value of E minus 0, which is the number of matched characters. So 5 minus 0 is 5. Shift this pattern 5 times to the right. I is matched with I, J, B. Now what you do? You have to calculate again both d1 and d2 because some of the characters are matched. What is d1? d1 is equal to shift value of B minus the number of matched characters, which is 1 here. So what is shift value of B? B shift value is 5. 5 minus 1, 4. What is d2? Please here, I and I have matched. So see here, if I is there, only I is matched, then the d2 is 2. So out of 4 and 2, maximum is 4. You shift this pattern 4 times to the right. Next, you take I with the underscore. There is immediate mismatch. So only calculate d1. d1 is 5 minus 0. The 5, what is 5? Shift value of underscore minus 0. Fine. So 5 times you shift it right. Next, I with D, immediate mismatch. Take shift value of D, which is 5 minus 0, 5. So if you shift this character 5 times, it will go outside the bound. And since there is no match, the Bayer-Moore algorithm prints no match. Okay, let us take this last example. Here the text is same and the pattern I have taken as DRIDI. So how to calculate the good suffix table? If you please observe here, the last character I, we'll start with the last I. This I occurs in the yellow colored character. So if you want to shift this I to the last I, it should be shifted 2 times. That's why d2 is 2. Next, if you see the last two characters DI, anywhere it occurs together. No, it doesn't occur. So it will be the length of the pattern. Length of the pattern. Yes, 5. Similarly, next the last three characters IDI, it doesn't occur together anywhere. So again, length of the pattern 5. And last one RIDI, again it doesn't occur anywhere in the pattern. So it will be 5. So remember here, what we are doing is we are trying to shift this pattern. If any character in the pattern matches, that character has to be shifted. That will be the value of d2. Next is we are calculating the bad shift table for this DRIDI. Start with the last button character, it is same as Hotspool. The shift value of D will be 1, right? I will be 2 and R will be 3. Now if you please observe here, next we start matching the pattern with the text. I is matched with I, D is matched with J, but mismatch occurs. So we have to calculate both D1 and D2 because some of the characters have matched, fine. The D1 is the shift value of the mismatched character, that is J minus number of characters matched, 1, right? What is shift value of J? Yeah, shift value of J is 5. 5 minus 1, 4. And what is D2? Since only one I has matched, you have to go refer this table, good suffix table. If one I matches, then you have to take the value as D2, fine. So that's why 2. So out of 4 and 2, the maximum is 4. So this particular character gets shifted 4 times. Fine. Next, I is matched with R, and here it doesn't match, as a result of which immediately we'll just calculate d1, right? And what is d1? Shift value of R minus 0. Shift value of R is 5. 5 minus 0. Shift value of R is 3. 3 minus 0 is 3. So this character gets shifted 3 times. Next, I is matched with B. Again, there is no match, so we'll just calculate only d1. Shift value of B minus 0. What is shift value of B? 5, right? 5 minus 0, 5. This character gets shifted 5 times. And I is matched with underscore. Immediately there is no match. Shift value of underscore minus 0. Shift value of underscore is again 5. So we'll just shift it 5 times. Next, again, I is matched with N. Shift value of N is 5. 5 minus 0 is 5. So here it gets matched. Right? This is the basic concept of Bayer-Moore. You will calculate two tables, bad suffix and good suffix. Bad shift table is same. It will be D1S minus K, where S is the mismatched text character and K is the number of characters matched. Good suffix table will be calculated like this. Fine. So I'll just conclude by giving this algorithm. The step one is, for a given pattern and the alphabet used in both the pattern and the text, construct the bad shift table as we have discussed earlier. Then using the pattern, construct the good suffix shift table as described earlier. Align the pattern against the beginning of the text. Repeat the following step until either a matching substring is found or the pattern reaches beyond the last character of the text. Starting with the last character in the pattern, compare the corresponding characters in the pattern and the text until all M character pairs are matched. Then stop, or a mismatching pair is encountered after k greater or equal to 0 character pairs are matched successfully. In the latter case, retrieve the entry T1C from C's column of the bad shift table, where C is the text's mismatched character. If k is greater than 0, also retrieve the corresponding D2 entry from the good suffix table. Shift the pattern to the right by the number of positions computed by the formula. So basically what it tells is, we are calculating D1 and D2, fine. D1 is the bad suffix calculated using T1C minus K, and D2 is the good suffix table. Fine, we will shift the pattern by the maximum of D1 and D2. That is the whole concept of wire mode. Thank you.